before we move on, Brother Muhammad from Oman, he has some doubts. Yesterday we said that the sunnah is to pray the witr prayer, 3 rak'ahs, with 1 salam, but without sitting in the 2nd rak'ah for the 1st tashahhud. Because the Prophet ﷺ forbade us from simulating or praying witr as we pray maghrib. And we know that in maghrib, we sit in the 2nd rak'ah, and then we sit in the 3rd rak'ah, and after that we conclude our prayer. So the Prophet is saying, pray 3 in maghrib, but do not sit in the 2nd rak'ah, so that it would not be like maghrib. And by the way, just an extra bit of information, the Prophet, as Aisha, may Allah be pleased with her, told us that the Prophet used to offer witr 5 rak'ahs in a row, only sitting in the 5th. So the 1st, 2nd, 3rd, 4th, he would not sit. The 5th, he would sit, do tashahhud, and offer salam. And he would offer 7 rak'ahs as witr in one go. And he would only sit in the 7th rak'ah and then offer salams. And he also would offer 9 rak'ahs as witr, and he would only sit in the 8th and also in the 9th rak'ah as well. So this is the sunnah of the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam. So Brother Muhammad from Oman is asking about the witr. How can we pray behind someone who is clearly going against the Prophet's instruction not to pray the witr like maghrib? And I clarified this yesterday, and I said, though you and I believe that this is against the sunnah, the imam who's following that madhab believes that it is part of the sunnah. And he thinks that maybe the hadith we're following is weak, or maybe he is blindly following his shuyukh and the imam and the scholars of his school of thought. Therefore, he actually is not thinking that he's doing a sin. And that is why the scholars say that if you pray behind him while he believes what he's doing is correct, your prayer is valid as well. A lot of the imams don't raise their hands when they bow and raise their heads from bowing. We know that this is an authentic sunnah without any doubt. It's in the Sahih al-Bukhari and elsewhere. There's no doubt in it at all. Yet people still remain defiant and say, no, we follow our school of thought. This must be fabricated. You tell them it's in Bukhari. They say, we don't know Bukhari. They're ignorant. They don't have any knowledge. So if I pray behind them, would I say, no, they're doing something that is against the sunnah, or they're doing this? This is what they believe. So therefore, instead of wasting the night prayer by only praying 8 rak'ahs behind them or 20 rak'ahs behind them, and then going back to home and praying 3 rak'ahs or 1 rak'ah witr, by doing this, you would have wasted the reward of praying the whole night from Isha to Fajr. Because this is what the Prophet ﷺ said. And that is why scholars say, pray behind him and follow him in his 3 rak'ahs witr like the Maghrib. And if there is any burden, it would be against him, and you are exempted from that, inshallah.